Good morning. And welcome to this very beautiful day. Thank you for being here. Thank you for taking time out of your schedule. However, this is a very, very important day for us to reflect on all of those that served and paid the ultimate sacrifice. I would like to mention that we do have restrooms here behind this facility if anyone does need those. I'm going to ask that all veterans and active military personnel to please stand and to be recognized. Thank you for your service. At this time, I would like to recognize a couple of special guests that we have here. I'd like to recognize former town supervisor Channing Philbrick. Town attorney Richard Horwitz. We have the Honorable Matthew Rosenbaum, Supreme Court Justice. The Honorable John DeMarco, County Court Justice. We have our county legislators, Debbie Draw of the 9th LD, and George Hebert of the 15th LD. We have members of the Coast Guard that have joined us here today. Thank you for all of them. Thank you for your service. And we have Captain Andy Delisire, who is the A-Zone Captain here with us, representing Monroe County Sheriff's Department. And I would be remiss if I didn't recognize our very own Penfield Emergency Volunteer Ambulance Corps. They're here. If anyone is not feeling well, with the heat gets to you or anything like that, please see them. They're out in the crowd, and thank you for your service. I'd ask that everyone please rise for the Pledge of Allegiance led by Boy Scout Troop 312. 312 has been with us here and has done a wonderful job setting everything up and making all this happen. So gentlemen, when you're ready. Thank you. Thank you, gentlemen. And I'd like to recognize the following Penfield High School students that will honor us with the national anthem. Alexis Holleran, John Freiberg, Dominic Termino, Ethan Conway, Maggie Marcus, Elizabeth Trulli, Ariana Pryor, and Haley Orndt.
Bursting
Ladies and gentlemen, thank you. That was beautiful. And I will call on the Reverend Stephen Brotzman, who is with the First Baptist Church of Penfield, for our invocation.
So we pray. God of all nations, God of all peoples, we thank you for this opportunity to gather today. We ask that you'll be here, ministering to our hearts, filling us with your love, giving us your dreams, giving us your hopes. Lord, as we remember those who bravely gave their lives, men and women who died in service to their country, help us to remember that they died so that we might have peace and freedom. And help us to make the most of the canopy of peace and freedom that they have afforded us. We pray all these things. I pray these things in the name of Jesus. Amen.
Good morning again, everyone. I'm Councilwoman Paula Metzler from the Penfield Town Board, and it's my honor today to introduce our guest speaker. Nick Stefanovic was born and raised in Rochester, New York. He joined the Marine Corps in 2002, served multiple tours overseas, and was honorably discharged in 2006. Like many veterans who return home, his transition was difficult. And for 3 years, he struggled to readapt to civilian society and thrive in employment. In 2009, Nick found his salvation in the Veterans Treatment Court. He used this program to reintroduce himself to the structure and motivation that the Marine Corps had provided him, yet he lacked after his discharge. After completing the Veterans Court in Rochester, Nick went on to receive his bachelor's degree in substance abuse counseling and became a therapist. He also began to speak publicly from the perspective of a veteran who struggled with adapting to a civilian mindset. Nick has spoken at conferences and events across the country. He has appeared on nationally broadcasted programs like Hardball with Chris Matthews, Diane Rain, Take Part Live, the CBS Nightly News, CNN, and many others. He has testified before Congress, presented at the White House, and has worked individually with the past three secretaries of the Veterans Administration. During his public advocacy, Nick decided to further his education and went on to receive his master's degree in public administration. He has worked as a judicial assessment specialist for the New York State court system, and for the past 5 years as a consultant for Justice for Vets, Center for Court Innovation, and the National Institute of Corrections. In 2017, Nick authored a national publication that was edited and released by the National Institute of Corrections, titled Barracks Behind Bars. In January of 2018, Nick was appointed by Monroe County Executive Cheryl Donolfo to the Director of the Monroe County Veterans Service Agency. He continues in this role to advocate for veterans on all levels, serves as the Vice Chairman on the Board of Directors for the Veterans Outreach Center, and as a member on various other boards. It is my privilege this morning to introduce my great friend and Penfield resident, Nick Stefanovic.
Good morning, and thank you all for being here. I have some prepared remarks, but before I do those, I just want to thank a few people. Some have already been acknowledged, but these individuals help us throughout the year make sure that the sacrifice that men and women who serve in the military make is always worth it. I want to acknowledge Judge John DeMarco for everything he's done for the Veterans Treatment Court and saving the lives of hundreds of veterans as he presided over that court. Paula, thank you so much. You know, Paula is, is a perfect example of someone who knows what it is to serve, as having her nephew join the Army recently, and he'll be deploying soon. Also want to thank Town Board Member Andy Moore for what he did recently at the Rochester Airport. And within the next couple of weeks, we'll be setting up a table of honor there. So if you're in the Rochester Airport, make sure you take a look. It'll be right outside of TSA. So thank you, Andy, for that. And Tony LaFountain, for everything he does for the town of Penfield and bringing us all together on a day like this. This is an unbelievable venue, and it's really great. Thank you, Tony. And my wife, Erin, who's sitting right there. And I also see Rick Goff sitting out there, years of service. Thank you, Rick. John Stalvey, Norman Anderson, Dan McClenny, Justin Thacker. It is these names that define my Memorial Day. These are the men from my unit that did not return home. Throughout the history of mankind, there have been few things that have remained consistent. The outlook on war has changed, but the perpetuation of it has not. There will always be war, and for very clear reasons. There will always be groups of people that will try and oppress, pillage, murder, and conquer other groups of people. It's an unfortunate part of human nature, but it is real. Within us all exists some degree of the desire for power, along with an element of fear. It's the combination of these two that lead masses of people to commit atrocities. I would admit, thankfully, that for most of us, the desire for peace, equality, freedom, and goodwill outweighs that of the desire for power and the enslavement to fear. But for a significant minority, that is not the case. Every person seated here before me is fortunate. We are fortunate to live in a country where we do not live in fear of encountering a checkpoint on our way home, where we would be pulled from our cars, robbed, and possibly killed, depending on what sect of religion we claim. Our women are fortunate that they do not require, by law, a man to walk 10 feet in front of them, and they do not have to live in fear of selling their 9-year-old daughters off to an older man who will abuse them. Our children are fortunate that they can receive an education and be afforded the opportunity to excel in areas where they are talented. I say this is good fortune because I believe that in the grand scheme of things, it is luck that determines where we are born in the world. I certainly am not more deserving than a man born in Iraq or Afghanistan. It would be absurd for me to claim that America has not had its share of problems. We have much progress to make on a number of issues, but it remains true that compared to the rest of the world, we are fortunate. As I continued to deploy in support of Operation Enduring Freedom and Operation Iraqi Freedom, the purpose for my service evolved. I was a young, naive 19-year-old boy who joined the Marine Corps with two of my friends after 9/11. I was told by the surrounding community that I was protecting America, defending our freedoms. By the time we had gotten to our final deployment, I had figured out that the true purpose for why we keep returning to war was the people, the Afghan people, the Iraqi people, American people. There are a few sentiments that I have experienced from others in my time as a veteran. There are people that say the countries we are involved in are not oppressed by dictatorships and brutal regimes, and the only real reason we send our troops there is because we want oil or money. I have heard that those people have their problems and we have ours, so we need to stay out of their business. I can't tell you about the decisions that were made in the Situation Room at the White House because I wasn't there. Most of the people seated here before me were not there. I can only tell you what my brothers and I fought for on the ground. I'm going to share a few examples of what I'm talking about and tell you about one of my closest friends. I'm not interested in telling war stories, as I do believe that the details of war are meant to be known by those who experience them and are sacred. I do find it relevant to share some in order to explain the importance of the day we're here to honor. The people of Afghanistan were some of the most honorable people I've ever met. I lived in the Northeast tribal regions for most of the time I was there. It is the case that the civilians there are no different from those of us sitting here today in every way except for their environment. They live in an environment of fear. The Taliban ruled that country with an iron fist. If you disagreed with a policy and were brave enough to make it known, you were killed. If you were a woman and had an affair, you were publicly executed. If you were determined to be gay, you were publicly executed. That's their way of life. We grew to love the people there, especially the children. My friend would oftentimes fall behind in his own duty because he loved to hand out candy and coins to the kids. Every time they saw him coming, they would surround him and wave their hands. He would complain because it was only the boys that were allowed to do this, with the exception of the very young girls. My friend hated the fact that the people had to live this way. I heard him correct other Marines when they used the term Haji when talking about the Afghan people. "These people aren't Hajis," he would say. "Those people are." And he would gesture up toward the mountains. In the region we operated in, the Taliban forces roamed like nomads in the mountains, as these mountains were sitting on top of a network of cave systems that gave them a place to run and hide after carrying out attacks. During one visit to a Kalat in northern Afghanistan, my friend and I were speaking with a tribal elder inside of his home. After a brief conversation and us letting him know why we were there, he informed us that if he were to walk outside with us and cooperate, we would leave, and about 30 minutes after, they will come down from the mountains and they will kill his family. They will not kill him because they need him. It's an environment of fear. Further on in our deployment, we would be called in for support by an Army Special Forces team to a town called Zorman. The SF team had set up a small base there, and they were receiving threats from the Taliban element residing in that region. It was common. They were fine with the threats until they received a credible threat that there would be harm done to the civilians in the town if they did not leave. We received the call and prepared for a 2-hour drive to this town. 1 hour into the drive, my lieutenant turned back to me and told me to inform the rest of the platoon that the enemy blew up a school and that we would be heading straight to the site. They blew up an elementary school. We spent the next 48 hours digging bodies out of rubble in an attempt to match them up with the parents who would take them home and prepare a burial. If my friend would have been there for this, it would have broken him. He loved those children. Sometimes I'm glad that he wasn't around when this happened. He wasn't around because on June 24th, 2004, we were ambushed in a valley near Barakaut, Afghanistan. My friend's team was cut off from me and surrounded on three sides. He fought not for himself, but for those who were being oppressed by the same men firing at him then until he was overrun. 8 rounds were fired into his abdomen, and he died of blood loss before we could repel the attacking force. I can say with confidence that there is nobody here now who is more anti-war than I am. Through my experience, I have learned that war will be a part of the human race until we are gone from the face of the earth. That is not to say that diplomacy is not our most important strategy. Countless lives have been saved through the use of diplomacy. The unfortunate truth is that for groups like the Taliban, time spent being diplomatic often equals lives lost. It is important to acknowledge this because it helps us to understand the true meaning behind Memorial Day. My friend's name is Justin. He died because he loved the people of Afghanistan, and he refused to run from those who brought suffering upon them He died fighting for humanity. I believe that part of what defines us as humans is the obligation and responsibility for those of us who have the strength and capability to protect and defend those who cannot defend themselves. I believe strongly that before we are Americans, we are human beings. When I returned home, Justin's memory was the source of grief, guilt, sadness, pain, and anger. As I was saved by some very important people around me, some sitting here before me, I have been able to transform his memory from that into a source of motivation, success, and pride. Memorial Day will have a different meaning for those of us who fought than it will for anyone else. I won't celebrate on this day. I will often be overcome with sadness and guilt on this day. But I hope that this message can help us share some common sentiment for Memorial Day. I hope we can all agree that those who gave their life out of love for humanity deserve to be honored. I want to end my message with a quote that I find to be extremely relevant on this holiday from the Irish philosopher Edmund Burke. He said, "The only thing necessary for the triumph of evil is for good men to do nothing." Again, I want to thank everyone for coming and helping us to celebrate the lives of these brave men and women who gave their lives in order to make sure that we could come together like this and thank the town of Penfield.
Thank you, Nick. At this time, I would like to recognize the Penfield Pops Band conductor, Ken Scott.
Thank you. John Cacavas, or Cacavas, however you'd like to pronounce it. That name is not a household name. But his music certainly is. If you have been around in last century and early part of this century, and obviously you are, then you've heard his music, you've listened to his music, and you've listened to it quite a bit and listened to it regularly. He was an Army veteran, served during World War II. After a year in the infantry, his skills as a composer and arranger were recognized, and for the rest of his service, he was the chief composer and arranger of the Army Band in Washington, D.C. Now, as I read more and more about him, I started thinking, I'm going to have to make a list, because there's no way I'm going to remember all of his compositions or most of the compositions that I think you would recognize. So if you'll give me a moment, I will just give you names of probably the ones that I think you would recognize the most. These are John Cacavas' compositions. He wrote the theme to the TV series Kojak. He wrote the music for the original Hawaii Five-O. He wrote music for Airport 75 and Airport 77. Buck Rogers in the 25th Century, the Bionic Woman. He wrote the music for the 1978 remake of The Time Machine, music for Hangar 18. He wrote what became a jazz standard, How Insensitive. He wrote music for three of the James Bond movies, Diamonds Are Forever, Moonraker, and Goldfinger. I'm sure you recognize more than a few of those titles. We're going to play a march piece that he wrote. It's very common. It's part of the literature for public schools. It's simply called Days of Glory. Thank you.
Good afternoon. The procession of roses is a unique and moving Memorial Day tradition here in Penfield. Members of the community and community organizations will present roses which symbolize the service and sacrifice of our veterans and those in active duty. When your name is read, please pick up a flag from the person up front by the last row of chairs. Proceed with the flag up to the roses at the top of the hill. Replace one of the roses with your flag. After placing the flag, we encourage you to leave your rose at the memorial at the top of the hill. If you feel you may need some assistance getting to the top of the hill, please let one of our Boy Scouts know as you pick up your flag, and they will assist you in walking. We'll go ahead and start. American Legion Bremen Post 1229, in memory of Peter Bremen, U.S. Army killed in action in France, Robert Bremen, U.S. Army killed in action in France, Colin Story, U.S. Air Force, World War II. Richard Goff, in memory of Robert H. Goff, U.S. Army Air Corps, World War II, Gregory Joseph Goff, U.S. Marine Corps, and George Willen, 53rd Kentucky Mounted Infantry, Civil War. Patricia Goff, in memory of William Bitz Vogel, U.S. Army, World War II, Frank Vagley, U.S. Marines, World War II, Joseph Uckotter, U.S. Navy, World War II, and Ann Uckotter, U.S. Navy, World War II. Tony LaFountain and family, in honor of members of the Donovan, LaFountain, Emmons, and Warden families who have served in the military. The Metzler, Krenzer, and Casey families, in memory of Corporal David Casey, U.S. Army, Korea. Nick Stefanovic, for County Executive Cheryl Danolfo, in honor and the selfless men and women who bravely made the ultimate sacrifice fighting for our freedom. Nick is also representing Justin Thacker. Joseph Simeone, U.S. Navy, in memory of all those who fought in the Korean War. Joyce Strawhand, Mark and Darlene Smith, Laura and Travis Miller, in memory of Sergeant Andrew Strahand, U.S. Air Force, Korea. Boy Scout Troop 312, in honor of all past and present members of Troop 312 who are serving who have served to protect our country. Cindy Daniel Bouchards, in memory of Bruce Daniels, U.S. Navy, World War II, Len Bouchard, U.S. Army, Vietnam, Bert Daniels, U.S. Army, World War II, Rex Daniels, U.S. Army, killed in action, Vietnam, 1971, and Joe Skane, U.S. Marines, World War II. Melinda Falkoff, in memory of Sergeant Norman Grauld, U.S. Army Medical Corps, World War II, Royal Merkel, U.S. Army, World War II, Martha Anderson Merkel, U.S. Coast Guard, World War II, and Douglas Chancellor, U.S. Army, Vietnam. Bob and Barbara Quinn, in memory of Sergeant Anthony Andolino, U.S. Army, World War II, Sergeant Robert Quinn, U.S. Army, World War II, and Sergeant Gabriel Brooks, U.S. Army, World War II. The Delameter family, in memory of First Sergeant Carlton J. Delameter, U.S. Army, Germany. Penfield Voluntary Emergency Ambulance, in honor of the selfless men and women who bravely made the ultimate sacrifice fighting for our freedoms. Tim and Sue Murphy, in honor of Lieutenant Dan Murphy, U.S. Navy active duty, and in memory of Ensign Sean Duffy, U.S. Navy aviator, and Petty Officer Matthew Cantor, U.S. Navy Special Operations. Peggy O'Neill for the Penfield Public Library, in memory of Staff Sergeant Wilbert H. Cooper, U.S. Army 94th Infantry, 301st Field Artillery, Battle of the Bulge. Rick and Judy Johnson, in memory of Brian Schramm, U.S. Marine Corps, killed in action, Iraq War. Frank Capuano, U.S. Marine Corps, killed in action, Vietnam. And Robert Bruce Moutrie, U.S. Army, World War II. Debbie Holloway, in memory of Arthur Wasanke, U.S. Army, and Harold Wasanke, U.S. Army. Chuck Fox, in memory of W. Robert Fox, U.S. Navy. Penfield Business Chamber, in honor of the selfless men and women of Penfield, who so bravely made the ultimate sacrifice fighting for our freedoms. Penfield Rotary, in honor of the selfless men and women who so bravely made the ultimate sacrifice fighting for our freedoms. Elmer Pankratz, in memory of Richard Light, Army Air Force B-26 bomber pilot killed in action. Barb Baziars, for the Penfield School District, in honor of the selfless men and women who so bravely made the ultimate sacrifice protecting our freedoms. Samuel and Roseanne Hodgetts, in memory of Private Joseph J. Tomino, U.S. Army Marauders CBI Theater in World War II, and Corporal James P. Hodgetts, U.S. Marines. Richard Horwitz, in honor of the selfless men and women who so bravely made the ultimate sacrifice protecting our freedoms. Zone A Captain Andrew DeLicer for the Monroe County Sheriff's Office and Monroe County Sheriff Todd Baxter, in honor of the selfless men and women who made the ultimate sacrifice in protecting our freedoms. Kelly LaPola Hoagie and family, in memory of Staff Sergeant John A. LaPola, U.S. Army O Company, 75th Infantry, 82nd Airborne Division, killed in action April 15, 1969, Vietnam. Dr. Terry Allen and Commander John Allen, U.S. Coast Guard retired, in honor of Robert Flynn, U.S. Army retired, Lieutenant Junior Grade Gordon Allen, U.S. Coast Guard retired, Commander Michael Flint, U.S. Coast Guard, and Lieutenant Elizabeth Flint, U.S. Coast Guard. Burton W. Turner, in memory of Charles W. Turner, U.S. Navy, World War II. Mary R. Turner, in memory of Specialist 4, William R.J. Mandel, U.S. Army, Vietnam. Jean Hoskins, in memory of Private First Class E3 David Charles DeGage, U.S. Army, Vietnam. Linda M. McGrain, in memory of Private First Class Harold L. Mandel, U.S. Army, World War II. Coast Guard Station Rochester, in honor of the selfless men and women who bravely made the ultimate sacrifice protecting our freedoms. Jim Howe, in honor of Seaman Robert T. Howe, U.S. Navy, and Ensign John Martin Hudson, U.S. Navy. Paul Fichette, in memory of Staff Sergeant Joseph Fichette, U.S. Army 102nd Infantry Division, World War II, Battle of the Bulge. Christine and Tom Shaw and family, in memory of Thomas H. Shaw, U.S. Navy, and in honor of John Machulis, U.S. Marines, Sergeant Bernard A. Shaw, U.S. Marines, Matthew K. McCaffrey, U.S. Marines and Navy, Jason B. Ladd, U.S. Marines, and Costas Machulis, U.S. Army. Monroe County Legislator Debbie Draw, in memory of Private First Class Thomas Quinlan, U.S. Army Purple Heart recipient. Paul Dondorfer, in memory of Sam Perry, U.S. Army. Penfield Fire Company, in honor of the selfless men and women who so bravely made the ultimate sacrifice in protecting our freedoms. Tara Dumont, in memory of Robert Johnston, U.S. Marines, and Steno Del Monte, U.S. Air Force. St. Joseph's Church and St. Joseph's Council of the Knights of Columbus, in honor of the selfless men and women who so bravely made the ultimate sacrifice serving our country. Nancy Hammond, in memory of Captain Charles G. Kynes, U.S. Marines, Vietnam. Don Hoyler, in memory of Technical Sergeant Ed Hoyler, U.S. Army, World War II. New York State Supreme Court Justice, Honorable Judge Matthew Rosenbaum, in memory of Lieutenant Clarence Bergman, U.S. Army Air Corps, World War II, Sergeant High Bergman, U.S. Army World War II, Lieutenant First Class Harry Bergman, U.S. Army World War II, Petty Officer Jerry Bergman, U.S. Navy World War II, Pharmacist Mate First Class Charles B. Leston, U.S. Navy World War II, and in honor of William Rockwood, MASH Unit, Korean Conflict. The Penfield Parenton Kiwanis Club, in honor of all the selfless men and women who bravely made the ultimate sacrifice in protecting our freedoms. Monroe County Court Judge, the Honorable John DeMarco, in honor of all the selfless men and women who served bravely and made the ultimate sacrifice in protecting our country. Thank you.
Good morning. Thank you for being here today. My name is Sabrina Renner. Before giving our essay awards, I would like to take a moment to remember a man who played a significant role in this contest since its inception, Mr. Andrew Strawhand. Mr. Strawhand passionately served his country and his community. He served overseas and stateside in the U.S. Air Force during the Korean War. He was a 40-year volunteer with West Webster Fire Department, an EMT instructor, member of Webster Area Exempts, and commander of VFW Post 820 Penfield. During his service in the VFW post, Andy was instrumental in the building of our Veterans Memorial, several flagpoles in Penfield Parks, and this annual essay contest for Penfield Middle School students. Andy passed away this past March at the age of 87. For a number of years before the dissolution of VFW Post 820, Andy and I worked closely on the coordination of this event. We became friends. And although he had a gruff exterior, he was a kind and gentle man. His passion and dedication will be missed. I ask you now to please join me in a moment of silence in memory of Mr. Andrew Strawhand. Thank you.
Good morning, and thank you, Sabrina, for doing that. That was very important. Andy really was so much a part of this. It's amazing not to have him here today, so he's in our thoughts. Essay Contest Awards. The VFW Post 820 began this contest many years ago. Upon the post dissolution in 2014, they made a generous donation to the town to continue the contest. This year's topic was Why I Honor the American Flag. The American Legion, Bremen Post 1229, and Penfield Rotary judged the essays. The winners were third place, Teaghan O'Donnell, sixth grade, Bay Trail, second place, Lauren Salvador, sixth grade, Bay Trail, and first place, Shreya Bhattacharya. Did I get it? Anyway, so we wanted to have each of the applicants, winners, come up and read theirs, and then we'll give her a certificate afterwards. So I guess we're going to start with the third place. Teaghan O'Donnell, are you here? Teaghan, there you are.
Why I Honor the American Flag. I truly believe everyone in this wondrous nation should honor the American flag. Many people have died fighting for this country. Our nation is something we all should be proud of. Soldiers fight day after day, battle after battle for our safety. When we see white stars with a background of blue and stripes of red and white, we salute. As the niece and granddaughter of veterans, I know the risks and sacrifices that go into keeping our flag flying. People don't just get picked and told they must defend a flag. They do it willingly. By choosing to be part of our armed forces, they know they are putting their lives on the line for our country. When I say the pledge, I know I am honoring them, our nation, and our flag. Our flag has been with us throughout many, many difficult situations and flown proud and tall. It has crossed the Delaware River with George Washington, flown on battlefields during the Civil War, stood on top of Mount Suribachi during the Battle of Iwo Jima during World War II, and even landed on the moon. Former Congressman Mike Fitzpatrick once said, "The American flag is the symbol of our freedom, national pride, and history." How much more honorable could our flag be? He was speaking the truth when he said those words. That is what our country stands for and what our flag flies for. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. What an honorable statement. I will pledge my loyalty to my country over and over again. one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. I know God looks down upon us and has blessed us with this united, undivided country. We are the home of the free-willed and brilliant-minded. We offer justice not just to the few, not just to the most, but to all. I always wondered what the colors of our flag stand for. Now it all comes together. Red stands for hardiness and courage. We are strong and brave. White stands for purity and innocence. We are true and pristine. Blue stands for vigilance, perseverance, and justice. We have a safe, supportive country. I am thankful for our flag, and everyone in our country should be too. When our flag waves, don't slump, salute. We are liberty, we are justice, and we are all America.
Very good. And then we have something for you. It's your certificate of recognition and your award from the American Legion.
Thank you.
Thank you. Very good. And next is Lauren Salvador, second place winner. Lauren?
Why I honor the American flag. If someone asks you why our flag is important, say this. The American flag does not fly because the wind moves it. The American flag flies because of the last breath of every military member who has died defending it. The United States is a place where people can believe their own beliefs, live their own lives, and are entitled to equal treatment under the law. It is a place where people can be free. The American flag shows who we are and where we came from. Our flag, also known as Old Glory, Stars and Stripes, or the Star-Spangled Banner, flies because over 1 million soldiers died defending it, protecting it from the countries and people who wished to destroy it. They died, were injured, and fought to keep others alive. Every time I see an American flag, whether a small one on a wooden stick in the garden of a neighbor's house, or a tall one in front of a library or a school, I think of our soldiers going to war to protect it, our country, and all of us. So the next time you see an American flag, think about how that flag shows that we are able to live freely, safely, and happily because of the soldiers and veterans who will never let our enemies destroy us. I remember in elementary school when every year on Veterans Day, our school held a celebration. Kids and teachers invited relatives who were veterans. We all gathered in the cafeteria, sang patriotic songs, and read the names of all the veterans and who they were related to. Just being in the audience those days made me realize what they did to keep our flag standing and alive was just amazing. It really touched my heart that those veterans were willing to risk their lives for their country. How strong could they possibly be? I love America. I want to live here forever. The American flag is a symbol of freedom and liberty. It followed George Washington across the Delaware. It is so important that it even has a place on the moon. So when I'm asked why I honor the American flag, I say one thing. I honor the flag because I focus on what unites us rather than what divides us.
That was great. Thank you. Here's your certificate. American Legion. Thank you. And first place, we'll say it again, Shreya Bhattacharya. Welcome.
Why I honor the American flag. We pledge our allegiance to the flag every day in school by reciting these words. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. But do we really understand the true meaning of what we say? Our country was almost split in two during the Civil War by blinding rage and corruption. But thanks to our strong leader, Abraham Lincoln, we pulled through. President Lincoln guided the United States through hard times by issuing the Emancipation Proclamation. He gave all Americans the liberty and justice they deserved. When I look at the American flag, I see all the great events that have happened throughout our history. I see the resilience and the persistence the brave colonists had against the British during the Revolutionary War. I see the kindness and care the fearless American soldiers gave to help the imprisoned Jews and other victims of the Holocaust. I see the compassion given by the determined rescue workers during Hurricane Florence and Hurricane Michael. I'm so honored to be an American because of all the kindness we have shown each other. We have also cried tears for the sorrowful events that have happened to us, including the bombing of Pearl Harbor, the assassination of President John F. Kennedy, and the 9/11 attacks. We have always bounced back from these and other tragedies and kept fighting for our country. When I see the American flag waving through the air, I feel a sense of pride. Our flag has the battle scars of a 242-year-old veteran, but Americans always fight for justice. Francis Scott Key was inspired to write a poem in 1814 after he witnessed the attack on Fort McHenry. In 1931, that poem became our national anthem. Our star-spangled banner has continued to wave in triumph throughout the years. We are triumphant thanks to our military. Those courageous heroes are always striving to protect the United States at all costs. Without them, our country would fall apart. The American flag bonds us together through our differences. It makes a quilt out of our many threads. Even though we have different religions, opinions, ideas, and cultures, we create a beautiful harmony that connects us all. We live as one nation together through the ups and downs of being true Americans.
That was great. Here is your certificate and the medal. And they'll be getting it. So I want to thank all three girls. They're great, Teaghan and Lauren and Shreya, for their essays. And we will move on to the next part of the program.
Shreya reminded me that I may have missed an individual, one of our dignitaries, Paul Dondorfer, Penfield resident. He was a first responder at 9/11. He is now serves in Rochester Police Department and is representing the men and women of Rochester Police Department today. Paul, thank you. I had mentioned earlier that we are so honored to have Troop 312 with us, and they have been with us here every year that I can remember. Their ranks have swelled, and if you take a look, and I ask everyone to please give your attention to our monument on the hill, I'll ask that the members of Troop 312 Boy Scouts, if they will lead us in the next phase of this wonderful ceremony. Thank you. Thank you. You may be seated. I would like to again recognize the Penfield Pops Band and conductor Ken Scott, who does a fabulous job for us at this ceremony each and every year. I'd like to recognize Sabrina. Thank you. Yes. I'd like to recognize our Penfield Recreation Department and Sabrina Renner. Sabrina puts this together each year, coordinates the essay activity and all the logistics. And Sabrina, thank you. Penfield TV and everything that they do for our community to capture all of these wonderful events so that you can enjoy them, or those that may not have been here have the opportunity to enjoy them. I would like to recognize Bracola Gardens. Bracola Gardens does a fabulous job of providing all the flowers that you see here today. Thank you. And to part of our foundation, Boy Scout Troop 312, thank you for all of your efforts, guys. Thank you. Thank you for being here today to honor and remember the sacrifices that so many men and women across the United States have made so that we can enjoy the life of freedom that we do today. As you leave here today to enjoy your families and friends, picnics, pools, and gardens, please keep all of these brave men and women in your hearts and remember the purpose of this Memorial Day. Please take a minute to visit the memorial at the top of the hill dedicated to the folks from Penfield who lost their lives for us in battle. Let us not take for granted the freedoms they brought for us at such a high price. Let their sacrifices not be in vain. I ask today, whatever you're doing around 3 o'clock, if you could just pause and have a moment of silence for all of those that gave so much for all of us. Thank you very much for attending today. Thank you, everyone, for all of your support of this wonderful event. I'll ask that Reverend Stephen Brotzman please come to the podium for the benediction. Thank you.
Now receive the benediction. May you know the love of God. May you experience the peace of God. May you fulfill God's vision for your life. And may you enjoy the safety of God's protection until we meet again. Amen.
End you off with a piece by Robert Sheldon. It's simply called Encanto.